On the 11th of July, 1962, the first transatlantic television transmission was accomplished. A new satellite would handle it called Telstar. But Telstar had a problem. It was not a geosynchronous satellite. Today's satellites are all along a line above the equator, and they stay where they are. That's why, once you've pointed a dish at them, if something awful doesn't happen, well, you're in like Flynn. So if Telstar didn't stay parked, what was it doing? Well, it was orbiting. And it took a complex apparatus of movable aiming dishes, both in the U.S. and in Europe, to follow it. And it was only visible from both sides of the Atlantic for about 4 minutes during each pass. And it had to go to sleep for 2 hours so its solar batteries could be recharged. Clunky as it was worth it. On both sides of the pond, TV sets were carrying live reports. There was even a piece of a JFK live news conference.
I understand the part of today's press conference is being relayed by the Telstar communications satellite, and this is another indication of the extraordinary world in which we live.
Even a rock group called the Tornadoes had a one-hit wonder with a song called Telstar. Telstar only worked for 7 months. It was damaged by a high-altitude nuclear test. It was eventually replaced with a network of geosynchronous satellites, first predicted back in 1945 by Arthur C. Clarke. Today there are 7,000 satellites orbiting the Earth. Half of them work, half of them don't. I'm Dennis Staley.